We'll consider there the wideband optical amplifier. Now in this wideband optical amplifier, the word wideband, just like your amplifier, is to be work for this wideband of your operation there. So nowadays, if you see that we are communicating for this longer distance communication, but along with that, if supposed to be your the link will work for this wideband, so then we need to use that wideband operation. And that wideband, for this wideband operation, we need to design a wideband optical amplifier. And that wideband optical amplifier is to be worked for the different wavelength band, and that will work for this different wavelength division multiplexing application. We'll see that wavelength division multiplexing. So wavelength division multiplexing means what? We have the different wavelength, and that are combined, and that is to be transmitted there. So in this wideband optical amplifier, we are just combining here the two amplifier, and that are operating at the C band, or that are operating at the L band, or we can say that S band or a U band. So there are the different bands of a optical amplifier, and we are using that optical amplifier. We are combining the two band here, and then the two bands are combining, and then we'll provide the effective amplification for these two particular band there. So either S band, L band, C band, L band, or C band, S band, L band, S band, likewise. So the different combinations of this optical amplifier is there. So that's why this is called as a wideband optical amplifier, because the individual optical amplifier provides a gain for the specific band. If we are combining the two different band, so then we can say that that means these two bands will work for these two different wavelength, or at a different wavelength. So that's why it is called as a wideband optical amplifier. So here we are a amplifier combinations that can be in terms of a parallel, or we can say that a optical combination, it will be in terms of a series here. You can see that here a C band, we say that C band, and a L band, a input here. So here we have C oblique L band, that is D max. Then we can say that a C band EDFA, then we have this L band EDFA. Then we have a gain flattening filter 1, GFF 1, then GFF 2 here, and then we are combining both C oblique L band, MUX here, and then we'll get the output, that is C band and a L band output. Now this is about a combination. If you see that, these are just like a two different optical band, optical amplifier in a parallel. So this is nothing but a parallel combination. Okay, this one is nothing but a parallel combination. Another optical amplifier, that two different band will work in a series operation. So we can suppose to be say that we have that input is about a C band and a L band input. Then we have this C band PDF A. Then we have this gain flattening filter equalizer, that is for the given particular wavelength we supposed to be say for that particular band. Then we have the L band, that will be the PDF A. Then we have this GFF2 here, and then we'll get that output. That output is nothing but what we can say that the C band and a L band output. Now here this one is nothing but what we say, it is about the series combination of that a L band and a C band. Now if you consider here, because we say here, now from this particular figure, if you see, consider that a C band EDFA, L band EDFA. So means that amplifier will work for the specific band. So we are saying that a EDFA band, that for EDFA amplifier, that will work for the C band, or that can be work for the L band, or that can be work for this S band likewise. So according to that, we have to choose that particular band filter, band amplifier. So here we have used the EDFA. So even you can combine that instead of EDFA, we can use a Raman amplifier, and that Raman amplifier can be operating at this different band. Okay, so likewise. So we have the combination of this parallel and series. Okay, combination of this parallel and series amplifier. So we'll get that output for these two different bands. So that's why it is called as a wideband amplifier. So in the case of a parallel combination, you can see that here directly straightforward here. So we have this a wideband demultiplexer here. So we can, these are the two input, that C band and L band, both the inputs are there. And then demultiplexer split that whatever the input signal coming from these two different wavelength band to the specific band here. So that is a C band and L band there. And that C band and L band will propagating to this corresponding amplifier. So we'll get that amplified output of this corresponding band here. And then in between that particular band, a C band and L band, so we supposed to be considered that if the band is specified for this given particular wavelength. I mean, C band is for a specific wavelength, L band is for the specific wavelength. So in between that a band, there should be some guard band. So because of that particular guard band, that two spectral bands can be separated easily. So I mean, C band will be separate and L band will be separate. So in between that, there will be a guard band. So means a two spectral band or two spectral region will be separated by this particular guard band. And this guard band will be used to prevent the amplification overlap between these two different band or these two different amplifier there, or these two different amplifier will not interfere because of this particular a guard band available in these two. Okay, so that's why we can say that we can use a guard band to avoid that interference from the adjacent amplifier. So in addition to that, they have some unusable wavelength band. So that's why the disadvantage of this particular parallel configuration is there. So means it will wastage that particular band. So that's why, so we can say that we are using this specific band of operation, but that wastage of band will be occur in this combination, parallel combination there. So here we require that a wavelength division multiplexer here before and after of each an amplifier. So because of that, there may be a small system insertion loss because of that insertion there. So that is about a parallel combination. Then in the series combination here, here we can suppose to be provide that this stop is splitting the band, a separate complete band is providing. So means we can say that here we have the C band and L band, both the inputs are there, and then that will be propagating through this band here. So now these amplifiers are connected together. When your signals are propagating through that specific band, okay, so you can say that, and according to that specific band, amplification will be takes place there. And then we can suppose to be use that a GFF here after that amplification for the specific band amplification. So we can combine these both and we'll get the output. So we can use the combination of EDFA amplifier, or we can use the combination of EDFA and a Raman amplifier that will be operating at the specific band. So we can use a hybrid type of a structure by using this two different amplifier, and that is about a wideband optical amplifier, and this is about the optical amplifier that we have seen today. And we will combine, we just differentiate that optical amplifier, that is about a semiconductor amplifier and EDFA here, because the Raman scattering amplifier principle is used, that is for the scattering only. So most of the cases the people are use iridium dope fiber amplifier, that is iridium dopant, that is iridium 3 dopant element are used for the amplification there. And if you compare that, a semiconductor optical amplifier, that is about, it is the band of a 1300 nanometer to or a 1550 nanometer band. For the specific band, S band, L band likewise. But if you consider that EDFA amplifier, that will work for the specific band of, that is about a 1550 nanometer band only. So semiconductor optical amplifier, it has a high power output. But because even we say that a high power output, it has a high coupling loss, because we are connecting that amplifier to the fiber. So that's why there may be a coupling loss. That's why you can say that it has a high coupling loss. So it is integrable. So we can specifically, you can use for this different band, or we can use for the different link there. And it has a non-linearities in this optical amplifier. So if you compare that a EDFA here, so it has a high gain. Because of that high gain, we can say that a high power amplifier, low crosstalk, because it will specifically work for the specific band there, low coupling losses, because the active medium is a different, but in the active medium here the fiber is used, so that's why it has a low coupling loss. It has a low noise, because the low crosstalk, low noise, and it is a polarization insensitive. Polarization, we have seen that earlier, that is for this given particular polarization your amplifier is to work. So with this, we can stop here, and we have seen today that is about a three main optical amplifier. And that three amplifiers are classified as the semiconductor optical amplifier, that is SOA. Then we have seen that a iridium dope fiber amplifier. And then we have seen that a Raman amplifier. Now if you consider that this, all the optical amplifier, they are increasing that optical power level of that incident light through the stimulated emission or through the optical transmission or optical power transmission process. In the case of SOA and EDFA, the mechanism is used here, a population inversion, means we can say that external pump source is used for the stimulated emission. and we can use that a pump source supply the energy to the active medium, and then that will raise their energy level from the lower energy state to the higher energy state, and then it will produce the population inversion there. And because that incoming signal will trigger that excited electrons to drop to the lower level, and then a stimulated emission process will be takes place. So that is about a principle used in a SOA and EDFA. But in the case of a Raman amplifier, the principle is used is about a stimulated Raman scattering, and that stimulated Raman scattering is generated at that same specific signal. So that's why it will produce that scattering output will scattered output level that will provide the energy to the signal at that particular wavelength band. So that is about the optical amplifier that we have learned. And if you compare that a Raman optical amplifier, it is just like a non-linear. It is based on the non-linear effect, and that non-linear effect is called as a stimulated Raman scattering, and it provides the amplification at the optical power level. Okay, so that is about we have seen today, and that's all from this optical amplifier topic. Thank you all of you.